Most respected dear family members, my pranams to you. When I was doing the recording of Living Now, Living Today, subject in Malayalam, many people requested me that I should translate that in English and also should upload. How to live now? Why to live now? I am sure you might not have got the correct message what I wanted to convey. I just wanted to convey you a simple, small message that majority of us, we are living now, we are living today, thinking about the past, worrying about the past, and feeling bad about the past. Another group of people, they live today thinking only about tomorrow and the future. I'm not telling that you should not think about yesterdays and you should not think about tomorrows. But for us, today is more important than yesterday and tomorrow, because yesterday is a cancelled check, tomorrow is an unwritten check, and today is ready cash in our hand. We can decide how to live now, N-O-W. We can take inspiration from the past. That needs only few minutes. We can prepare for the future. That also needs few minutes. For preparing tomorrow and take inspiration from the past, take lessons from the past, we have to live today happily and with great contentment. So living now is more important. Suppose tomorrow is the last day for us and today has gone, naturally we will have to feel bad that we did not even use the last day. So when you are living today, try to do good things, try to do positive actions and activities. What you have done yesterday should not create a problem for you today, and what you are doing today should not create a problem for you tomorrow. What you said yesterday should not create a problem for you today, and what you said today or what you are saying today should not create a problem for you tomorrow. But remember that yesterdays cannot be corrected. Yesterdays have gone forever. So worrying what happened, thinking what happened, and evaluating what happened yesterday, as far as business angle point is concerned, may be useful. But for a life, for living, preparation for living is not life. Experience of living is life. So for living now, think about now, analyze about now, and do the things, say the matters in the most positive way, which should not create a problem for your own worry. That's very important. If you are missing the chance every minute, and you know that today the sun rose at about 6:15, 6:15 over, 7:15 over, 8:15 over, 9:15 over, and this day will also will become over. And when you are looking back when the sunset, what you have gained from sunrise to sunset. If somebody is telling you to write down the points what you could get today, majority of the people may have to write one or two words or one or two lines, and some people may have to think, will have to think for minutes together to write even what they gained today. So I wish to convey you that intentionally and with a conviction, deliberately do good things today. Do good things today. Prepare today. Note down what all the things that you have to do today in a paper or in a daily workbook, including whether you have to write an SMS, you have to telephone somebody, you have to send an email, you have to write a book, you have to go to bank, you have to go to somewhere. Write the list of the work and do it systematically and customatically. Once you have done the work, tick mark that work and feel satisfied that you have done the work. Nothing remains in pending. I use the word customatically, knowing pretty well that such a word is not there in dictionary. Then why did I use? No Englishman has told that you should not make your own English words. That is why I am making it. When the message is clear, then I can make my own words. You can also. So remember, today if you are writing down all the points, all the work, all your mission to be fulfilled, then today you could get what you wanted to get. What you wanted to get, you could get today, you are getting today. If you are taking lunch, my request to you, don't eat lunch, make it a feast type of eating. The dogs eat its food, the cow eats the grass, but human being is not eating just like animals do. We have to enjoy, and that enjoyment should not create a negative in future. So take the lunch, take a cup of tea, take a chocolate if you are interested in taking. And every minute of eating, every minute of drinking a tea or coffee, you should enjoy it. Because sometimes I used to say, one bowl of rice or food may be staying about 4 seconds or 5 seconds on your tongue. 4 or 5 seconds on your tongue. After a simple chewing, it will be going inside. Once that food has gone inside, there is no taste at all. And like that, then during lunch or dinner, you may be taking about 20 handful of rice or some snacks. So 4 seconds or 5 seconds into 20, 100 seconds. You are sitting for the lunch and enjoying the food only for 100 seconds. 100 seconds means slightly above 1 minute and a half. You are taking about 2 hours, 3 hours for preparing the lunch and eating the lunch for 1 minute and a half. And that 1 minute and a half itself, if you are not enjoying, what does it mean? Wasting that energy. Many people used to contact me from Middle East countries and say that I am very much worried. The moment your work has become a burden for you, then every part of the work will be a burden for you. The moment you start hating your work, you start worrying your work, The moment you start thinking negatively about your work, from that moment onwards, your work will be a burden for you and you will not be interested in even in going to the office. Your body will drag back. So my request, every work what you are doing in your office, try to enjoy that. Create a mind which has got attachment with the work. Many sannyasis and many discourse giving, delivering people used to say, get detached. Wrong. You should have attachment with your work. You should have attachment with your supervisors. You should have attachment with your subordinates. But you should not have bondage with your office. You should not have bondage with your supervisors, bondage with your subordinates, because nothing in this world is permanent. Everything in this world is temporary. And just like the sun rises and sunsets, just like the people are born and people die, just like the season changes, just like the incidents come and go, as Lord Krishna told in Bhagavad Gita 51 and a half century ago, Agama Vayino Anitya Tam Titikshasva Bharata. The material will come, the matter will come, the issue will come, the problem will come, the issue for enjoyment and issue for worry will come, and they will go, they will not stay. Even your happiness and sorrow are temporary, not permanent. So in your office, get attached with everything. You should have attachment. Bandham is needed. Bandhanam should be avoided. Bondage should be avoided. And you know that our own people, when they enter the office, they work for some time and they leave. Particularly corporate structure, people may not stay for long. They are even not worried about the bond they have to give to the office, 5 lakhs or something like that. They will be just giving and going. So it is applicable for you also. Don't create a bondage, but create an attachment. And remember that if you are not enjoying today, others cannot come to you and even discuss with you if you are keeping a rotten pumpkin face. People want to see everyone happy even though they are unhappy. People want to see others laughing even though they are crying. So people will not come to you if you are keeping a sad face. Nobody in the world would like to see a negative face at all. So my request to you, live on today. Note down all the work that you have to do. Tick mark whatever you have done. Working is not the problem. Thinking about working is the problem for many people. We are worrying not about the issue. We are worrying about thinking about the issue. We worry about the thoughts. Thoughts are produced in the mind and worries also produced in the mind, whereas work is produced in the body. Once work is over, that is over. But when worry is started, it may not be over. It may come up just like the waves in the ocean. So the mind is getting disturbed, the body generally will not. So whatever is to be done using your body, do it. Enjoy it and cherish your work. Let your home become a good divine devalaya, temple. Let your office also become a temple. There you are working for you and for others. You are making money for you and for your family. Your family is waiting for you. Without money, family, people will not even bother about you. And And suppose your office work is becoming a burden for you, try to get another work. Don't go on murmuring and cursing others. In Bhagavad Gita, it is told, Uddhare Atman Atmanam. You have to elevate yourself. You have to progress yourself. You have to develop yourself. You have to march forward by yourself. Others may support or others may not support. That depends upon your character and behavior. So Uddhare Atman Atmanam. Live on today. Elevate yourself today. Na Atmanam Avasadayeta. Never denigrate yourself. Never degrade yourself. Never belittle yourself. Never make fun of yourself. Not only yourself. Never degrade your supervisors. Never degrade your subordinates. Never degrade your colleagues. Never degrade your family members. Because without them you are not there. Without you they will be there. Without them you will not be there. Without you they will be there. So your presence for them should give them happiness through your behavior and character, for which you have to live now. For which you have to live a happy life. First you make yourself happy. Then only you can make others happy. If you are not happy, then do you think that you can make others happy? You know how to make dosa? First the pan should get heated. Then only the dough, the paste will get heated. Without the pan getting heated, how can you make a dosa? You cannot. So for transferring heat from the dosa pan to the dough, first heat should be there in the pan. If you want to make others happy, first you should become happy. If you want to make others angry, then you should become angry first. Then only you can make others angry using rotten words. So live now. And you know, in Indian history and Indian epics and Indian Puranas, almost all the stories are connected with the kings and the sannyasis. Why it is? Both of them should be very happy. The king should be happy to rule the people, and king should first elevate himself, should become happy. Then only he can make his prajas, citizens, happy. If the king is worried 24 hours, he cannot make his citizens and people happy. And a sannyasi can bless others, telling that Pashyema Sharadashadam, Jiveema Sharadashadam, Srinuvama Sharadashadam, Modema Sharadashadam. So nicely, Swadusham Sada Pidaro Yodaha, Krishre Shrida Shakti Vandoga Viraha, Chitra Sena Ishubala Amradra Sado Vira Vravo Vradasaha. Let our forefathers become happy for making us happy. This is the Vedic prayer. Sangachadvam Samvadatvam Sambho Manam Sijanata Deva Bhagam Yada Purve Sanjana Upasate Samano Mandra Samiti Samani Samanam Manasaha Chittamesha Samanam Mandram Abhimandra Yeva Samanena Voha Vishajugomi Samaniva Abhuti Samana Hrudayanivaha Samanamastu Omano Yadavasu Sahasati Samanamastu Omano Yadavasu Sahasati Samanamastu. Let us become equally happy for living Yadavasu Sahasati. Living a happy, enjoyable, laughing, smiling, pleasant life. As long as we live here, let us become happy. And remember that gadasuna gadasumscha na anushojanti pandita. Whatever is gone, yesterday is gone. But learn lesson from yesterday and prepare your today's lesson and examination. And what you are going to get tomorrow, you are not sure about it. But do all good things for making tomorrow also good. So every today will become good for you. And you create your own heaven and you create your own hell. I am sure about it. you can become happy. You can worry, go on worrying continuously for 24 hours. If you are becoming happy, all the people standing nearby you will also become happy. If you are going on worrying, people will not come to you at all. They will go away from you. Because nobody in this world wants to cry, even though they are crying. Nobody in this world wants to listen even worrying news. They suddenly shifted to something else. They may be criticizing others. They may be denigrating others. But they do not want to see that they are criticized. They get denigrated. That they do not want. So live a happy life today. Every minute I would like to say, not even today, present. Live on now. N-O-W. You can make in your family, create a heavenly divine environment. Spend some time with your children. Spend some time with your wife and husband. Spend some time with your parents. Do not keep anything hidden. Be transparent and open. Tell the truth, tell the fact, tell the essence. And even if negatives come, remember that, that will come and that will go. It will not get retained. Just like even rising sun will not be a rising sun always. The sun will be going up and become a noon sun, then setting sun. And remember that nothing in this world is permanent. The only permanent thing in this world is that everything is temporary. Only permanent thing in this world is that everything is temporary. You are also temporary. Your feelings are also temporary. What you were worrying 1 month ago, about which you may not even be thinking now. What you were worrying 1 week back, about which you may not even be thinking now. So that worry is over. So think that at that time if you would not have worried, you did not have worried, you would have been happy then and now also. So problems will be there, as Kunti Mata in Bhagavadam. When Lord Krishna asked Kunti Mata, what do you want as blessing or boon? Kunti Mata said, I want to have problem in my life. Only one person in the world who always requested to have, who requested to have problems always. Why did she say like that? Problems are there in the life. Problems are there in the life. We are living for solving the problem. Solving the problem itself should become a mission. Solving the problem is life. Suppose you do not have any problem. Everything you get, you will have to just lie down on a bed without any problem. No wife, no children. No money problem, no food problem, nothing. I am sure that immediately you will get cholesterol problem inside, not from outside. Or you will get white collar diseases, heart problem, angiogram, cancer, and so on. Because you did not have other problems, so nature will have to give some problem to you also. Nature cannot keep an imbalance. Some people have got worry, some people do not have worry. Some people are sick, some other people are not sick. If some people are sick, some other people will have some other problem. So, we always used to say, the system will be adjusting in such a way that everyone has got happiness. Everyone has got worry and sorrow. It is equally distributed. And that equally distribution in which God has given you permission. Just like you see, Rama was going to kill Ravana, but nature gave lot of advice to Ravana. Nature gave lot of guidance to Ravana through Vibhishana, through Mandodari, through Trijada, and even through Kumbhakarna. But Ravana was not interested to change himself. He was adamant to the adharma. That is why he was punished. So when you are worrying, my request, people will be supporting you. People will be consoling you, guiding you, motivating you. But give your ears to them. Give your ears to them. Then you can immediately come back to the normal condition. But suppose you are not interested in listening. You are not interested in sharing and caring and curing. Then nobody in this world can change you, console you. So my request, be good to others, then others will be good to you. Be happy, then others will be happy to you. Behave nicely, then others will behave you nicely. Keep an optimistic viewpoint, others will also keep you the same thing. Be enjoying every minute, make others also enjoy in a positive sense. Remember that liquor and drugs are not the solution for the problem. Do not create problem, pain for others. I'm sure today you can live nicely. Every today is becoming good. Remember that whatever you have grabbed, whatever you have built, whatever you have made cheating others, they are not permanent. So don't cheat others. Don't follow corruption. Don't take a bribe. My request to you, don't follow an adharmic pathway. Don't follow an adharmic pathway, because for every action there is an equal and opposite reaction. You will have to suffer for the negative you have done. Sometimes part of that will also be transferred to your children. So don't do bad today, because the reaction we may come tomorrow. You can see many people are in the prison, many people are in the police station, many people are in the remand for the bad action they have done. We are seeing that, but we are not understanding that. Any bad thing you are doing, any bad deeds you are doing, for which you will have to suffer. So live nicely today. Live nicely today. Uddhareed atmanatmanam, elevate yourself. Na atmanam avasadayet, never denigrate yourself. Elevate yourself, elevate your family, elevate your society, and elevate your nation. Never denigrate yourself. Never denigrate your family. Never denigrate your society. Never denigrate the nation. Atma iva hyatmano banduhu. You yourself is your closest relative. Atma iva nipuratmana. If you are not properly using yourself, you will become your own enemy. You should not become your own enemy. You should become your own friend. I, one letter, V, W, E, two letters, U, three letters, they, four letters, group, five letters. Which is easy to change? I, capital I is easy to change. So change yourself. I am trying to change myself. Every minute I want to keep a smiling face. If possible, you also try. It does not mean that we do not have worries. We have got worries. The problem for worrying will come, problem for worrying will go. Then if you are happy, that is an asset for you always. So, my pranams to you. Thank you very much.